Hi everyone. It is hard to say anything other than this has been an extremely emotional night for all of us. There's just no getting around that. When Live PD started, it was something that I know we all looked on as being taking cops one step further, and the fact that what we were seeing was indeed live, and that you put a whole different set of risks on that because if it is live, there's to be no editing. Tonight, I think we saw close to what may be the worst fears that we would possibly have had. And to have had a baby used by a man as a buffer. And as I said in one of the previous commentaries, I know that there are those who will just continue to say, well, we must understand the backgrounds of people like this. No, I'm sorry, I'm going to answer that. We must not understand the backgrounds of people like that, or we can choose not to understand the backgrounds of people like that, because there is absolutely no excuse for harming a baby under any circumstances. Thank goodness, as we just heard from Kevin Lawrence, the baby's safe and everybody's prayers are answered. A lot of tonight took me back to my earliest years as a reporter. I started in television as a reporter and anchor 41 years ago. And I recall the first shooting. I was tweeting about this to someone tonight. I recall the first shooting that I was sent to. It was in downtown Columbus, Georgia. Now, you want to talk about something frivolous? It turned out that it was an uncle who shot his nephew and ultimately killed him because the nephew took a Tab soda out of the refrigerator. The uncle had told him not to do it three different times, and the fourth time the uncle decided he was going to shoot him over a Tab. I have covered many different scenes over the years that certainly you just shake your head at and you just wonder, why do these things happen? But almost in all of those instances, it was the aftermath. When you hear the police call, and you head to the scene, and usually it's over, unless it's, say, a hostage situation where they're trying to get someone out of a home. But tonight, seeing what we did live is just something that I've never seen before in my life, and I never hope to see it again. But in, I suppose, the past 6 weeks, I've had an opportunity to talk to some of our local police officers in Jackson, Tennessee, to get their thoughts on Live PD. And I talked to Barry Michael, who is our deputy police chief. He has been on the gang squad. He has been the chief drug investigator in this county. He's a man who I respect greatly. And I asked him, Barry happens to be a big fan of this show. And I asked him, I said, what if something were to happen extremely violent, that you actually had a police officer who ended up being shot or possibly killed, and it happened while it was on live television? Or I used an example, an incident that might be like the one we saw tonight. And he said one of the reasons that he would support that is because, he said, it is important for people to see what we go through and how we go through it night after night, particularly those working the night shift and are dealing with it in potentially high crime areas. And he said the show serves a great purpose. And if it ends up that an officer ends up in harm's way, as Chris Mastrianni was tonight, he said it's just an example of what happens to us constantly. So nonetheless, it's been a tough night for all of us to look at. But I hope that we have learned something from this, that as much as we appreciate our officers, seeing what they encounter, and something, again, I think it hit all of us because it was a child, seeing what they encounter night after night, like this one tonight. As I said earlier, there are just no words. But our prayers will be for Chris Mastrianni, because this is something emotionally, a lot of people don't realize this. This is not something when you're a police officer, a deputy sheriff, or any other type of law enforcement officer, you don't just shake this off. You don't just go home and say, well, it was all in a night's work. I have a feeling he's going to have to be doing some decompressing. And so we need to pray for that. I happen to work with a counselor who deals with police officers who do And she actually does the decompressing with them when they're on high crime scenes, when they've seen murders, when they've been in a violent situation. So our prayers for Chris Mastrianni that he can deal with this and in the days to come put this in perspective. But knowing that there's a little trauma and some post-trauma that goes along with this. Anyway, it's been a tough night for all of us, but I enjoy being part of this group and this family who watches every week, because I know all of you there appreciate law enforcement officers in the same way that I do. Many of you are probably related or married to some. I'm Steve Beverly, and I'll see you next Friday night.